Welcome to today's show. You may think I'm on the Missouri River dodging jumping Asian carp, but no, the guest on today's show, he uses one of these and one of these for a living, and he won the Jennings Award in 2012. A few words from our sponsor. We'll be right back, and we're going to go catch some big muskies and great big smallmouth with today's guest.
Whether it's panfish or trout you're after, you have to check out the amazing Chena bait. This action bait works great with small hooks or jigs included with the package. The small compact container fits in any tackle box. Chena bait comes in a 3-inch roll, and one small strip will allow you to catch 30 to 40 panfish. Chena bait works great both summer and winter. Get your Chena bait today. Call 1-888-203-3373. That's 1-888-203-3373. The amazing Chena bait. Call right now.
Hey folks, I'm Will Bradison, co-host of Fishing Wisconsin TV. When I'm not out catching fish with Bill Spahn, I'm selling real estate for Century 21. Whether you're looking right here in South Central Wisconsin, across state lines, or even across the country to buy, sell, or build, give me a call, I can help. I can be reached at 608-345-6090. My email is will, W-I-L-L, at c21affiliated.com.
Volleyball, pool, darts, and horseshoe leagues. KD's in Lodi has it all. And don't forget their Friday night fish fry. Relax at the outdoor bar or sneak inside and catch your favorite game on any of their 13 high-def TV sets. Family, friends, and fun at KD's in Lodi.
So you played for the All-Stars?
Yeah, I was an All-Star in 2012.
Oh, how was that?
That was cool.
Playing with the very best.
Yeah. I felt out of place there. Like all the guys I kind of grew up watching or idolized, and it was crazy.
That was really neat.
They were asking me for my autograph. It felt like a little weird.
Really?
Yeah, it was cool.
Did you guys
win?
No,
we won the skills competition. We lost the game. But
was that the outdoor one? They play outdoors?
No, it was in Ottawa. So I got traded away from Ottawa the year before, and then I came back the next year as an All-Star because they were hosting the game. So it was like a little jab back at them.
Cool. All right, let's do her. Well, folks, you probably guessed my special guest by now. Brian Elliot is jumping in the boat with me. One of the premier goaltenders in the world. He won't admit it, but I watch him, and I know it. So, Brian, you excited about the Wisconsin River today?
Oh, so excited. I've been talking to you about it for a while now, so... happy to get out there and slam some.
You know, Brian, this helmet is about the sweetest thing I've ever seen. When I was a goaltender, they weren't like this. So I'm wondering, after we're done fishing today, can I have this? No? Shoot. We've tried to do this for a couple of years now, folks. We just never hooked up. Today's the day. We're going to go for big muskies and northern pike, hopefully. But we will catch some smallmouth bass. So, Brian, let's put the helmets down, which... You know, I was a goalie growing up, and man, this is a special day for me. I'm pumped. I hope I get you about a 50-inch muskie today, bud. We're going to have fun on the Wisconsin River, whether we catch fish or not. But, folks, we're going to catch some fish. So, Brian, let's put our stuff away, jump in the boat, and go get some.
Let's go.
Game on. Up in front of us, we got depth to our left and lower. So, yeah, we're going to fish smallies at first. We're so close, I want to give it a good shot. Get you a couple 18, 19s maybe in the boat right away, get you fired up, and then we'll go for some bigger fish after that.
Right on.
All right, sounds good, man. Let's get her done.
Current's kind of coming.
Oh, well. Oh, think we could do that, Brian? I could give it a whirl.
Good try.
I got a jet boat.
Exactly. Oh, you should just race them.
Yeah, there you go. Hey, Brian, what we're going to be doing right now is smallmouth bass.
Yep.
I've just got a little 6-inch black worm rigged up. Smallies love them. What I did for you there is a circle hook with a sinko. And I tell you, the circle hooks are fun because you don't have to set the hook. It's rigged wacky style. All you do is throw it out. You feel any weight at all, just reel it in. It's so simple, you're going to flip. And let's go get them. Just throw it up in your shore.
Let it fall off, rod tip up.
Let it just feel. Just think of a something dead floating down the river and a big smallie behind a rock looks up and grabs it. As soon as he does, just reel him in.
Just get the net right
out. I did have another hit here, Brian, so the fish are in here. Yeah, they're going to be grabbing that. And if you don't get grabbed, I got a worm rig for you. You can switch over to anytime you want. But like I said, that bait, my experience with it this spring was crazy. I couldn't even believe how easy it was and how many fish were eating it up.
How long do those worms, how many fish do you, can you catch on one of them before they kind of...
Well, you know, a lot of times when they get pretty beat up, I'll bite off the head of it and then rehook it a little further down.
Okay.
You know, so I mean, I try to get as much use as I can out of them. You know, the hook tears them up, the fish tear them up. All right, now we're getting into some good stuff, and it lasts all the way up to see the end of those rocks.
Okay.
That's about how this stretch goes. And, well, I tell you, I've caught some monster smallies out of here. Monster smallies.
I got one.
That could be a fish right there, buddy. Get out of there! Oh,
yeah.
Don't be showing me up yet, Mr. Superstar. Oh, yeah. Nice. Oh, your drag's a little loose.
Drag's loose.
There you go. Just keep it tight. Nice fish. You don't reel him up too far because you got a long rod there to grab him.
There we go.
Look where he's hooked, in the corner of the mouth.
Wow.
These circle hooks are incredible. I love them. I mean, Brian, how long have we been fishing?
5 minutes, maybe.
If Adam Birch is watching, I don't want to rub it in, Adam, but the two goalies are getting her done. It's a nice little smallie, but...
Nice little one.
Hey, it's a start. Nice job.
Right on.
Knuckles on the first one, buddy. Yabba!
Right on.
Let's get her done. So, Brian, I know in 2012, playing for the St. Louis Blues, you and the other goaltender combined won the Jennings Award. What was that like, or what does that mean exactly?
Yeah, it's pretty cool. I mean, it's more of a team award. You know, it's lowest goals against, so, you know, we obviously have a lot to do with it, but, you know, our team defense was really good, and we let in the least amount of goals during the regular season, so... It was pretty good, you know, coming off probably a season that I would like to forget the year before, and then, you know, making that switch to winning a trophy, an NHL award, is pretty special. So
that was pretty,
you know,
huge.
I set a modern day goals against average and save percentage that year, so it was kind of cool just to look back at that year and, you know, kind of see what you accomplished, and, you know, makes you hungrier for the next year to come, because you know you can do better come the next year.
I don't know how you can do much better than that, but it sure is awesome to watch. You know, I watched a few clips on YouTube, and man, you're fast. And it's almost like you know what's going to happen with that puck before it happens.
Yeah, that's, and a lot of people ask that, you know, how do you see it? And it's a lot about anticipation and watching the guy's blade, where he's going to shoot, what his possibilities are, his angles. He really doesn't have a lot, and you have to understand it to be able to, you know, really know, okay, well, he only has this half of the net to shoot at. All I really have to do is be patient, wait for it, and kind of bait him into it. It's like fishing. You got to bait him a little bit.
There you go. Well, man, I tell you, hats off to you. And, you know, being played the position, of course, when I was a young kid, it was the most fun I've ever had in any sport, because everything happens right where you're at.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, it's in front of you. You got five guys, big guys, fast guys, trying to get that little puck past you at up to 100 miles an hour. I mean, what more excitement could you even think of having?
Yeah, it's, you know, it's been said of the most important position in sports. That goes along with a quarterback or a pitcher in baseball. So.
Oh, for sure. But, well, congratulations on the Jennings, man. That's awesome. And you got a new fan for this year. I'm going to have to be watching you and Adam both. But I tell you, the NHL's for excitement has come so far in the past few years. I mean, you know, more fan participation, more excitement at the games, and it's just gotten to the point where it's really fun to watch.
Yeah, it's
I love it.
You know, dream come true ever since I was 5 years old. What everybody asks you what you want to be when you grow up, and it was always a hockey player, never a fireman or a police.
Really?
or an astronaut. It was always a hockey player.
Wow. Well, living your dream, man. You can't ask much, you know, much more than that.
Exactly.
Exactly.
I mean, you know, I probably could be a professional goalie, but, you know, I like fishing. You know, I'd like to put the pads on sometime and have Adam take a few shots at me. I know I can't move too fast anymore, but it sure would be fun to have a chance at stopping someone.
Oh, you'd still stop him, I'm sure.
That's a good one.
No, that's what's fun. We always, you know, we come back and train together, so it's, yeah. You know, he always tries to get me, I try to get him, and it keeps us both sharp. So.
Well, you guys won the NCAA championship being Badgers.
Yeah.
So what was that like?
Yeah, it was, you know, that was our goal from the very beginning, and it was actually when I came on my visit to Madison before I committed to school here, Adam was the first guy I got introduced to, and was like, he said, so you're the guy that's supposed to win us a championship, eh?
Really?
And, you know, it's funny, I was talking to my dad about that, and, you know, that's what happened, you know, 2 years later, so.
How cool is that?
It was, it was kind of cool.
And you guys remain good buds ever since?
Yeah, for sure. Not on the ice, but off the ice.
Yeah, I suppose.
Unless we're on the same team, but I don't know. That hasn't happened yet.
Wow. Cool. Yeah, well, good for you. Sticking to something you love and getting to the level you're at is amazing.
Yeah, it's been fun.
Yeah. Hey, Brian, I do visit Canada about once a year, so I kind of catch a little accent there, bud. So you must be a Canadian.
Yep.
So where'd you grow up? Where'd you start playing hockey?
Yeah, I grew up just north of Toronto, about 30, 40 minutes north, a town called Newmarket, Ontario, and, you know, it's a good suburb of Toronto. My dad worked downtown, and, you know, quiet place to grow up, and like going back every once in a while to see family and friends, but, you know, now kind of made Wisconsin my summer home between hockey seasons.
Yeah. Right on Lake Wisconsin. I mean, you got good fishing, you got the river close by. I mean, it is a great place to live. When you played high school hockey, I mean, were you a real standout at high school even for
being
a goalie?
In Canada, we don't usually play high school. I mean, I played at my, you know, my freshman year, grade 9 year, and we won the All-Ontario Championship, and I was, you know, starting goalie as, you know, one of the youngest guys on the team. But so once you get to a certain level in Ontario, it's you play your club hockey, and then you can't play high school anymore.
Really?
Because you're almost too good for that level. So it's a little different than that from, you know, the state's perspective.
Yeah.
But it's, you know, I grew up doing that and playing AAA travel hockey, and people do it here in the States too, but they have to travel, you know, if you're playing in Wisconsin, you're going to Minnesota, Chicago, St. Louis.
Mm-hmm.
But when I was growing up, I mean, you'd, some of my away games were closer than my home games, so there's a lot more competition, a lot more, less driving, I should say, but it's still, it's a big commitment by your parents, and I always tell the young guys coming up when they're doing hockey schools to really thank their parents for that, you know, taking them all those 6 a.m. practices that you got to get to.
And, you know, it seemed like for me, the younger you were, they made you get up the earliest. Like 4:35 in the morning at the arena.
Yeah.
And it's like, geez, it was tough.
Yeah, it's a little colder those early mornings than you expect. But you always have a smile on your face when you're out on the rink, though.
Always.
Oh, I think I got one.
A double, Brian. Oh, yours sounds pretty good. Mine's not too bad. Oh, mine's pretty good. How good is yours? Double. Double smallies. Oh, my, came off at the boat. Are you kidding me? That's got to be a double. I mean, come on. We were side by side there. You lost your worm. I got my worm, but I don't have my fish. Doubles. And I just said, boy, Brian, I think we ought to stick around here. This seems like a good spot.
Yeah.
Show everybody at home that little river smallie.
You
know,
go.
They're a little on the small side today, guys. I think we'll get bigger ones.
There we go.
That's cool. Hey, Brian, you know, I got to admit something I'm not real proud of, but when I was a goalie, I'd scrape the ice, you know, out in front of the net because the other goalie was doing it, and I really didn't know why I was doing it, but I wanted to look like I knew what I was doing.
Yeah.
So what's the real reasoning behind that?
Yeah, it's almost changing a little bit. It's mainly to create a little friction when you're sliding with your pads on the ice, because when the ice is just fresh and new and wet, it's if you push, you can kind of slide yourself way out of position.
So you don't slide out of
the area. So you don't slide out, yeah. So, but some guys want to be nice and quick along the ice, so they don't scrape it as much. But You know, I like to have a little bit of friction there so I'm not pushing too hard. And, you know, sometimes I get a little antsy and I push real hard and get yourself kind of, then you're kind of scrambling all over the place.
Yeah. But, wow, yeah, it's, okay.
Not many people know. I get that question asked a lot, but,
yeah.
You know, you find your own amount of friction and...
Yeah. Well, I know. I used to do it just because I saw other goalies doing it.
That's probably how it started. One guy did it and everybody else followed.
I always thought, and this is really dumb, I thought it would slow down the puck just in case I had one coming kind of slower.
Yeah.
And I could maybe grab it before it got in or, you know, a rebound.
I put a little extra snow against the posts just to make them...
Oh, really?
If they want to wrap it around. I guess I shouldn't tell you my secrets.
Yeah, really. Hey, and also... When you got one that hits the pipe, bang,
yeah.
Do most of those not go in the net, or do they bounce off your back, or is it, you just never know?
It really depends. I mean, it's just kind of luck.
Yeah.
They, you know, they call them the goalie's best friend.
Oh, they do.
But, you know, if it hits the post and goes out, you usually give it a little tap and say thanks. And, you know, it usually works out in the wash, though. Some, you know, you'll have... Half of them go in, half of them go out.
Do they?
So.
Yeah, to hear that ding, I mean, you hear it at home even. It's loud.
Yeah, actually, in the national championship game against Boston College, it was a 2-1 game, and with about 5 seconds left, the guy got it from the point, and every player on the ice was in front of me. So there was, you know, they had their goalie out, so there was 11 guys in front of me. I couldn't even see anything, and it came through, and... hit the post, came out, and the buzzer went. So that's how we won the championship. It was a little tense moment because had a hit there.
I just had a hit too.
yeah, it's intense, but I think I was the only one on the ice that actually knew it didn't go in.
Wow, cool. Look at, they're chasing. Look, they're coming after you, man. They're just going all over the boat. They're grabbing mine out everywhere.
That's crazy. I've never seen anything like that.
Did you see him chasing? Oh, you'll get there.
I wanted to let you know how much your kind words and your understanding meant to me. You helped me find some peace in the passing of my special friend.
When unconditional love deserves uncompromised care, contact us at Midwest Cremation Service.
I always thought I needed to take my car to the shop my insurance company told me. Luke, he explained to me it was my decision, not my insurance company.
That's right, Bill. Often folks stop in and tell us their insurance company wants them to go to another body shop, up to 30 miles away. Remember though, wherever you choose to have your repairs done, make sure it's your decision, not theirs. Give us a try.
Hey guys, now that we got the car looking brand new, what do you say we all jump in a boat and go fishing? Thanks, Luke. Once again, you guys did a fantastic job. I recommend you to everybody I know.
Hi, I'm Mike Durant from Prairie Jewelers in Sun Prairie. Been custom making jewelry for 30 years. I'll take your jewelry that you have, remodel it, recycle the gold, redo the diamonds, turn it into a brand new piece of jewelry that you'll be proud to hand down through generations.
The death of a pet is never easy for pet parents, but comforting surroundings and the attention to your needs is important to Midwest Cremation Service. Whether you choose to be a part of the process or not, Midwest Cremation Service is there for you during this time of loss.
Bring your whole family to the Midwest's largest fishing expo. All the latest in fishing technology, tackle, baits, boats, poles, and reels. Plan your next fishing adventure. Attend one of our many seminars and meet the pros. There's something for the whole family. At the Alliant Energy Center, just off the Beltline on John Nolan Drive. For more information, visit our website or give us a call at 608-245-1040. See you there.
For baby, another double. Better tighten that. There, bring them up. Oh, holy moly.
Wow.
Yeah, I'd say wow. Look at that fish. Are you kidding? Woo. Grab them right and lip them. Put your thumb right in there, but don't get that hook in them. This is a little bit embarrassing for a fisherman as myself, but Brian, I'm sure, go ahead, you got the hog. Look at that. I mean, it's like a baby coming out of him.
But nice. You got a dandy there, yeah. Brian. Good job. Let's go get them. We know where they are, folks. We're going to go get a bunch more.
All right.
Woo-hoo, get her done. Knuckles on that double.
Nice.
Hey, doubles.
Hey, they're right
in
there,
right? About drag, buddy. That drag. The big ones are going to get you. Oh, it's a nice little guy. Jumper. There you go. Nice job. I think either I'm a really good teacher or this guy can do a lot more than just play hockey.
Little guy. Settle down. Oh, came off in the boat. Yep.
Really frustrating.
Yeah, it was.
I mean, we're just kind of waiting, sitting around, and just wondering if you're going to play or...
Yeah, well, you usually try to, when you're training, you try to peak at a certain time, which is, you know, training camp or just the end of training camp, and we didn't know when the season was going to start. Yeah. So you'd almost peak, come back down, take a couple days right off, like almost a week off if the talks weren't going well.
Yeah.
And then... you know, try to peak again in a little bit when you thought the season was going to start, and then
so
it's just
did the team just make you keep practicing almost every single day, or?
Well, no, we did that on our own. The team can't really do anything.
Oh.
So we weren't allowed to talk to anybody with the team.
Wow.
It was a little weird, and then coming back to the team and talking to the people you weren't supposed to talk to was a little. Awkward, but
yeah. Well, hey, Brian, you've met a lot of people being in your sport, but have you ever met the great one, Gretzky?
Yeah, I actually had. We were at a golf tournament. He played for the St. Louis Blues for a couple seasons, so he came to our golf tournament this past year, and you know, I kind of wanted to meet him. I was nervous, didn't know what to say to him, but came up and had a buddy introduce me to him, and. You know, he knew what hometown I was from, and had a story about it too, because he played hockey in Newmarket, Ontario. He said he played for a coach that said, you know, who do you think you are? You'll never be a good player. Like, you think you're going to make it in the NHL?
Really?
And greatest to ever play the game.
I think if I was you, I'd have probably said, think you could get one by me?
Yeah, right. I don't want to push my luck. I know he probably could, so...
I don't know. Oops, here we go.
The same time.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, that's finally a gooder, better fish.
Nice.
Like, did I say gooder? He's not that big, but it's a better fish. My English teacher would say, Bill, are you kidding me?
That's
amazing. Well, he ain't bad. I mean, he's still not the size I'd like to see today, but, you know, it's a keeper bass. Are you going to stop that, buddy, or what? No? You better stop it. You got a double? Oh! Our third double, Brian.
Oh,
it's a shame we can't count it. I think it hit the pipe.
Yeah.
There you go, folks. Nice little river smallie. We got to get up there. We got somebody getting in on my spot. Oh, got to give one a kiss. See ya. Where's your mama? Where's your mama? I got to get No, stop it now. Oh, no. You're way ahead of me. Come on, that's not fair. Take a break.
Wait.
You can eat my sandwich. Stop the splashing in the back of the boat. Oh. This is getting ridiculous. Well, Brian, I know you're a darn good hockey player, but you are a darn good fisherman as well.
Thank you. Put the bait on and he took it right off.
How'd he hit?
Pretty hard.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Cool.
Looks like he's been caught before.
Catch and release. That's what we like. Oh, Brian, the smallmouth fishing today seems fantastic. Sorry about the muskies and northerns, but you know, you gotta fish for what's biting. So do you mind catching all these smallies?
No, it's fun. I almost had one there. It's awesome.
All right. We'll get those muskies and northerns another day.
Oh, for sure. That just makes you have to take me out one more time.
Oh, I'll take you out a bunch.
Hey, we're Mazinet Marina. 52 years on Lake Mendota, family owned and operated.
Right off M on Bluebill Park Drive South. Follow the signs.
Whether it's panfish or trout you're after, you have to check out the amazing Chena bait. This action bait works great with small hooks or jigs included with the package. The small compact container fits in any tackle box. Chena bait comes in a 3-inch roll, and one small strip will allow you to catch 30 to 40 panfish. Chena bait works great both summer and winter. Get your Chena bait today. Call 1-888-203-3373. That's 1-888-203-3373. The amazing Chena bait. Call right now.
I saw him too.
I got one too. Ooh, man, I had a big one. Oh, I had one, but he got underneath a log on me, man. He looks pretty good. Oh, Brian, there we go, buddy.
Oh, yeah.
I just said we're going to go get some bigger fish, folks, and look what Brian does on a second cast.
I saw him hit that,
what
too.
What a hog. And that was tight, wasn't it? Right up on shore.
Yeah, right up on shore.
Nice fish, man. That's 17, 18.
He came off.
Wow.
Settle down, buddy.
That's a sweet fish right there, folks. Nice job. What a beaut.
Right on.
Isn't that nice?
That's fun.
That's nice. Let's go get a bunch more of those pups. Nice. Here you go. Knuckles, Brad. That's nice. A good one, buddy. That's a good one.
Oh, he hit it again.
No way.
Yeah.
A good one? Oh, just constant pull. Don't get crazy on him. Nice one?
Oh, yeah.
I can't hardly turn around to see it.
She's a nice
one. Oh, the biggest one of the day, baby. Oh, Brian, you smoked it. Whoa. Hey, Brian, nice fish once again. I think I show you where they're at, and then you catch them for whatever reason, but that works. Hey, I really appreciate you being on my TV show today. We had a ball on the Wisconsin River. We didn't get any big muskies or northerns, but sure was fun fishing with you and getting to know you a little better. We got a lot of those smallies, though. That was kind of fun.
Yeah, we did. Yeah. And, thanks for having me on. This was an awesome experience, and now I know what river fishing's like.
Hey, we'll do it again for sure. I hope you have a great season with the St. Louis Blues this year and bring home that Stanley Cup. I'd like to kiss it one time. Hey, everybody, this is me and Brian Elliott keeping it real on the Wisconsin River. We'll see you guys next week.